How to make a voltage doubler. With a voltage doubler, we put in a certain AC voltage here, and we have at the output a DC voltage, and the DC voltage is approximately 2 times higher than the AC voltage. But there are a lot of things to tell about this circuit, and I want to do that in this video, and perhaps I'm gonna make 2 videos about this issue. In the first place, I've drawn here capacitors and diodes, and I've noted them here as a positive and a negative lead, also here. So that means that C1 and C2, this capacitor here and that capacitor here, could be electrolytics. But it can also be bipolar capacitors, like this, these ones. When you want to use electrolytics in such a circuit, I've done that here. Both capacitors here are electrolytics. There are a few things to take in account. In the first place, when you use here a high value electrolytic, you get a better result, and then in terms of power output at the output. So for instance, it differs when you use here a 1000 microfarad electrolytic or a 10 microfarad. When you use a 10 microfarad here, you will find also a higher voltage, but the power that you can derive at the output is not so high. So for good results, use here, for instance, in low voltage circuits, a high value capacitor, say 2000 microfarad. And also here 2000 microfarad. And in that case you can, for instance, double the input, say 12 volt AC to approximately 24 volts AC, DC. There is another thing to tell about this circuit. When you want to use diodes here, I've drawn here 2 diodes. These are diodes that are not made for high frequencies. So these diodes work properly on, say, 50 Hz or 60 Hz, but don't work properly on higher voltages. And you can use this voltage doubler, higher frequencies, and you can use this voltage doubler also on higher frequencies. For instance, when you want to use a high voltage coil from a television set, an old tube type television set, this coil works in many cases on 16 kilohertz. That means that these diodes are not very well usable, and in that case you have to use special high voltage diodes, like for instance the BI409 or these types of diodes. I want to show that now in the second page from this video. Here you see, for instance, a fuse. That means that such a fuse is only necessary when you have here a high current, say 500 milliampere or 1 ampere or 3 ampere. Such a high current can only be realized with high value capacitors, as I've told earlier, 1000 microfarad, 2000 microfarad. But here, when you want to use such a coil, we work in the milliampere range. And in that case, we have the same circuit. But we use now special high voltage diodes. 60 kHz is the output from a high voltage transformer in an old tube type television set, this transformer. And now we can use here a resistor to limit the output current. For instance, when we put in here to the voltage doubler for an oscilloscope tube, or say a tube amplifier, we can also use that circuit for a tube amplifier. We use here a resistor between 5k and 100k that limits the current. The capacitors here are have to have a low value, 100 nanofarad for instance, or 0.1 microfarad, that's the same. And we have here at the output also a very low capacitance capacitor. Here we use now high voltage diodes, these ones, this one or this one or that, this one. And you can use such a circuit to derive a high positive voltage here at the output, but also a high negative voltage. When you want a high negative voltage here, reverse the high voltage diode, here for instance, and here. When you do that, you have here a high negative voltage, and such a circuit is usable to supply, for instance, an oscilloscope tube that needs a voltage from 2000 volts between the cathode and the anode. I've drawn that here. Negative high voltage at the output goes to the cathode, and the positive lead from this high voltage circuit is connected to ground. And I want to refer to my earlier video about the oscilloscope. There I have explained this typical problem. And this is the best way to connect a one beam oscilloscope tube. Here we can only derive small currents from the circuit, say between 500 microampere and 3 or 5 milliampere. That of course also has a lot to do with the properties from the high voltage diode. This high voltage diode can handle approximately 5 or 10 ampere. This high voltage diode can handle only, as far as I know, 0.5 milliampere. Or 500 microampere, that's not much. Back to the earlier circuits. This is perhaps, for instance, a good intermezzo to tell. When you use a high voltage circuit, you can switch non-polar capacitors in series. Say that each capacitor is 1000 volts. At 100 nanofarad or 0.1 microfarad, the total capacitance and voltage rating is 4000 volt maximum. At 1/4 of 100 nanofarad is 25 nanofarad. And when you use, for instance, such a circuit to drive scope, it's not necessary to smoothen the high frequency voltage completely out, or in other words, the capacitor here from 100 nanofarad or 50 nanofarad is enough to get a good DC high voltage out for your oscilloscope tube. It doesn't need more smoothening. So the filtering effect in total is good enough. Back to the low voltage circuit. That was here, that's here. I put in now here at the circuit with electrolytic capacitors. By the way, this is 680 microfarad, this is 22 microfarad, so the combination is not ideal to get a high current, and we will see that later. I put in now here 25 volts AC. It's here from my power supply. And the output here, DC output, is here on the 250 volt scale, 75 volts. So perhaps you could think this is not a voltage doubler, but a voltage tripler. But what happens when we load the circuit? The circuit is now unloaded. So we have a high voltage here. When we load the circuit with two lamps, these are two lamps, each 12 volts, and the voltage drops back now to 50, 40, say 25 volts. And that could raise the question, what is the usefulness of such a circuit when we have at the output, when we load it substantially, still 25 volts. We put 25 volts AC in and 25 volts DC out. That's the result. Well, that has all to do with the current that you want to take out of such a circuit. This load here is too high given the capacitance from the capacitors here. When I use here, for instance, a 4000 microfarad capacitor and here a 2500 microfarad capacitor, you will see that the voltage here at the output is approximately 30 volts given this load. So there is a relation between the load that you want to apply, connect to the voltage doubler, and the current and the output voltage. So it's a useful circuit, but the crucial thing is here that the load, so what do you want to connect here to your circuit? The load is dependent also on the output voltage. So do some experiments, build this circuit for instance with two diodes, power diodes, 2000 microfarad capacitors, and test in your situation how high the voltage is given the load that your electronic circuit takes. And when it is low, say 10 milliampere, you will find a high voltage. When it is high, say for instance 500 milliampere or 1 ampere, the voltage will drop. The circuit is, however, very usable when you don't have a suitable transformer. For instance, you need here 24 volts. And you only have a transformer from 12 volts at, say, 1 ampere. Connect your 12 volt transformer here, and you will find here approximately 24 volts at, say, 500 milliampere or so. So it's a usable circuit. But you have to do some measurements and adapt it to your own personal situation in a specific electronic circuit. I've made this circuit many times, also used it, the high voltage circuit for a scope, also used it in an oscilloscope circuit. I always have used this transformer. This transformer has no high voltage diode built in, so I can connect here to this lead a tripler or a voltage doubler, and I have to say it works perfectly, especially on 16 kHz to drive a tube with special high voltage diodes.